In this video, you'll see how to extend your data warehouse to your data lake. Using a modern data architecture, you can move data from Amazon Redshift into an Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3, data lake, where it can be used to build visualizations with Amazon QuickSight and create machine learning, or ML, models with Amazon SageMaker. To get started, let's navigate to Amazon Redshift. For our purposes, we already have a two-node Redshift cluster. Let's open the Redshift Query Editor to review our infrastructure. We'll begin with this node. NYC Taxi is the name of our database. Within NYC Taxi, we see a spectrum schema and a taxi schema. Next, let's go to AWS Glue, where we have a job in place to load data from the S3 bucket into the Redshift database. The job reads SQL files in the S3 bucket, loads them into the Redshift data warehouse, and then transmits them back to S3 as Parquet files. Let's look at the Glue job in AWS Step Functions Workflow Studio. In the first node is the read filter job that reads and loads data from the S3 bucket into the NYC taxi schema as SQL files. Let's look at the script. This code creates a temporary table called NYC Green Taxi, and the data is then loaded into the taxi schema. The report job node transforms the material in the NYC taxi database into Parquet format and unloads the files back into the S3 bucket. Here you can see the code for taking the data from the NYC Green Taxi table and unloading it into the S3 bucket as a Parquet file. Let's apply and exit the workflow. Now we can return to our state machine and execute it. Let's return to the AWS Glue console to confirm the completion of both job runs. Here you can see that both jobs succeeded. Now we'll go to the Redshift Query Editor to run a query on the table we just created. Here we can see the table data. Now let's access the S3 bucket for our data lake and confirm the Parquet files loaded properly. As you can see, the NYC taxi schema data has been saved in Parquet format. Now that we have moved our data into the data lake, we can use visualizations and ML models to interpret the data. Before we do that, let's review the infrastructure we have set up to perform these analytics. In the AWS Glue Data Catalog, we have created a database to store copies of the data we'll use for analytics. We've also built and run a crawler to mine the Parquet files stored in the data lake and populate a table in the data catalog. Let's look at the table. Let's briefly review the dataset using Amazon Athena. The table has records including the date, distance, and fare earned from a vendor's taxi trips. Now that we have established the data lake, we can use Amazon QuickSight business intelligence tools to interpret and analyze the data. Let's ingest the data from our Redshift cluster database. Since we want to perform visualizations with data from the NYC Green Taxi table, we'll select the Taxi Schema table. At this point, we can preview the data. On the left is a complete list of fields, and at the bottom of the screen is our data set. We can adjust data types if necessary. Since we don't need to make adjustments, we can save and visualize the data set. For our first chart, let's graph a count of trips over time. To do this, we'll drag the data we need to the graph. The visualization now shows a count of trips over time by trip type. Let's add another graph to show the history of trip distances. For this, we'll need to add a calculated field. We'll name the field and supply the formula to compute. let's save the field. We'll use a clustered bar combo chart for this visualization. Let's apply the field we just created to the x-axis. Let's add the total amount and pick up date time fields to complete the graph. Here we can see the final visualization. We can also build ML models from Redshift data warehouse material. Let's go to our second Redshift cluster node to review the infrastructure we have set up for machine learning. This information schema involves sales data. Here are all the data sets included in the schema. We also have an external schema called Spectrum ML with an external table called Sales Raw. We have taken the raw sales data and added some custom filters to create a new table in the public schema called Sales Clean. Let's run this query. We'll use this table for building ML models using Amazon SageMaker. For demonstration purposes, our Jupyter Notebook instance is already running. The first step installs these packages. The next step imports AWS Data Wrangler, which is used to connect to the Redshift cluster. We already have our user connected. Next, we'll aggregate the data in the Sales Clean table and then split it into a training data set and a testing data set. Let's also run a time series forecasting model so we can visualize seasonality and any other noise apparent in the data. With this code, we'll create a time series forecast model. To do this, we'll implement a version of a standard method called the Autoregressive Integrated Moving Average, or AREMA. Here we can see the model that's been created. We'll also run a command that plots forecasted versus actual sales. Now we're going to run this command that contains a random product code to demonstrate pulling data from Redshift to use for machine learning. We'll forecast this data for the next 30 days and visualize the result. The blue line represents actual values, and the yellow line shows the forecast. We were able to use the same Redshift cluster for visualizing data as we did to build machine learning models. You've just seen how you can extend your data warehouse to your data lake. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.